The night Ronnie disappeared, I had felt a storm approaching, so I told Ronnie we'd go into a cave until it passed, but when I awoke the next morning, Ronnie was missing. I went out into the blizzard, but I couldn't smell him anywhere. I walked for days and nights, wandering around, hoping to pick up his scent. I was so worried about him, I couldn't even eat or sleep. I just prayed that there'd be some way to find my son, safe and sound. After weeks of searching, I met a fox that told me there was a website that can track animals without tagging them. I knew I could use this to find Ronnie. And from then on, I told every animal, tourist, researcher, and photographer I met to take a picture of any polar bear cubs they see. These photos can be uploaded onto a website where a NASA algorithm created by Edward Groth in 1986 can compare the photos to a photo of Ronnie. The algorithm was originally used to map the stars by forming triangles between every possible triplet of stars. It then compared the triangles' measurements to those in other images, determining any matches. The Groth algorithm was then incorporated into the Space Telescope Data Analysis System, which is a software that collaborates, analyzes, and reduces data gathered by the Hubble Space Telescope. In 2002, Jason Holmberg teamed with marine biologist Brad Norman, founder of the nonprofit EcoOcean, which studies the whale sharks that migrate annually through Western Australia's Ningaloo Marine Park. Norman had been tracking the Ningaloo sharks by photographing and identifying each shark from the unique white spots on its skin. The process was a tedious one. Norman had to examine and compare all photos by eye. Holmberg then contacted Dr. Zeyvan Arzumanian, an astrophysicist with the university's Space Research Association on contract at Goddard Space Flight Center. Together, they found and slightly modified the Groth algorithm to fit their tracking needs. And since its completion in 2005, the modified Groth algorithm has proven to be highly effective and accurate. Before, humans used to physically tag the sharks, but satellite tracking proved inefficient because the tags were frequently lost or rendered inoperative within weeks or a few months. And with plastic visual tags, less than 1% are spotted again after tagging. The algorithm, on the other hand, has already collected more than 3,000 usable whale shark photos, tagging more than 2,800 matches. EcoOcean's Whale Shark Photo Identification Library allows anyone to upload photos of whale sharks for comparison and identification. This helps researchers and scientists figure out their migratory patterns, behavior, and help protect them. Holmberg is now working on a simplified version of the software for easier use by individual researchers studying other species like me. In 2008, University of Central Florida adapted the whale shark algorithm to help track us polar bears, as we are a threatened species in the United States. Both the people and I can't afford to lose Ronnie. So they found a way to track us by using the whisker spots on our muzzles. And thankfully, after 9 long months, there was a match and I was finally reunited with my son. He had grown quite a lot.